I wanted to tell you all that what we just discussed, right? Hoarding about rainfall and about the farmers, you know, overusing pesticides, not having storage space and everything. These are called supply side problems. Okay, now we'll learn what the meaning of supply is. Now, when I'm talking about supply, supply is like the sister of demand. Okay, always, if you're going to read anything about demand, you'll always find the word supply somewhere or the other. It's always interlinked because demand is what we as consumers want, right? Our willingness plus ability. If you remember from last class, willingness to buy, ability to buy, right? And willingness, both of the things. Whereas supply is from the supplier's side, that is the person who will actually give me what I demand. It is from his side of things or from her side of things. The meaning of supply is the total amount, okay, of a specific good or service which is available to consumers. It is plain and simple and it is extremely easy. And I'm sure if I did not give you all the definition also, you all would be able to tell me, right? So supply is basically whatever goods or services are available for me to purchase that becomes a supply in the market. Now we'll see the next thing. Now, since we learned the law of demand last time, I'm going to ask you all this. Tell me, do you all remember the law of demand? Can somebody tell me?
May I?
Yes, go ahead.
When the price of the good increases, the quantity demanded decreases. And when the price decreases, the quantity demanded increases.
Very good. I'm so happy. Awesome. Great.
Thank you.
Okay. Now, that's about the, everyone else, Vedant, Aryan, Sneha, Sushmita, please respond to the poll. Even if you all weren't there last class, no problem. Maybe you all can see the presentation. It's fairly simple again, not very difficult. Okay. So the law of supply again is very similar to the law of demand. Now here, what happens? When the price of something increases, no, the quantity supplied increases. Because it's obvious, if somebody is telling me that you can sell this t-shirt for 10 rupees and you can sell this t-shirt for 20 rupees, what am I going to pick? I will pick obviously selling it at 20 rupees, right? Because I'm the supplier and I want to earn more money. So keeping, forget about other things, okay? Forget about what's going on in the world and only remember this line. When the price increases, as a supplier, I will increase my quantity supplied because I want to make more profits. And if the price falls, then I will decrease the quantity that I will supply. Now tell me if you understand the law of supply.
What is the question?
The question is if you understand the law of supply. Now that I explained it to you, do you understand it? Shenvita, did you not understand it? Do you want me to explain it again?
Yes.
Okay. So, I'll go to the next slide. Maybe I will understand it better now. Can you all see the slide properly?
Yes.
Okay. So, think like a supplier, okay? Now, you imagine yourself as somebody sitting in the store and you have to sell things to people. Okay, forget about all other things, okay, about what the customer will want, if the customer will buy or no, if I don't give discount, they won't buy. Forget about all those things. When you're thinking about a law, you only think about that one sentence. Don't think about anything else because there are so many other factors then to consider and you'll go mad. So don't think about anything, okay, just think about the law of supply. Now, imagine you're a supplier. What was the poll? Oh, it was to ask you if you understood the law of supply. Okay, fine. Now, see, think like a supplier again. So you're sitting at a shop and you have to sell a t-shirt. Now, if the t-shirt it is priced at 10 rupees, okay, and you know that you can increase the price, you will not sell so much of it because you know that at 10 rupees, you're only going to get 10 rupees from the customer. But if you can sell the same t-shirt, that one t-shirt at 20 rupees, will you not supply more? Then, yeah, and the same thing, if you can sell it at 30 instead, again, you're going to increase your quantity supplied. And if somebody tells you that, are why you're supplying, you know, one t-shirt for 10 rupees, when you can supply the same thing for 40 rupees. So what are you going to do? You're going to increase your quantity supply. So now do you understand the meaning of the law of supply? That when your price increases, the quantity that you supply will also increase. And when your price decreases, you're not going to supply so much. So your quantity supplied will also go down. Okay, Ahan said no. Ahan, can you tell me your doubt so I can clear it off? What about Vedant? Did you understand the law of supply? Okay. Yeah. Now we will see, like what I was telling you about the onion crisis, let's relate that to demand and supply now. Okay. So I'll tell you this. I've put it in the form of steps so that you can understand it more better. Now, what really happens? Why the onion crisis really occurred? Now, there were weather problems for sure, right? There must have been some situation with the rain. No doubt. Okay. There must have been some situation with the rain because of which the crops got destroyed. And maybe there were storage problems also, right? Now, because of that, the farmer was not able to supply enough of onions in the market. Now, what will happen to people like you and me? They are going to increase. Our demand is going to be the same, right? Now, tell me. Okay, fine. The demand is going to remain the same. But what we learned about in the first class and the second class, something called as scarcity, where there's not enough of resources or not enough of goods and services. Now, this again leads to a situation of scarcity because weather problems were there. Farmer was supposed to supply 100 kilos in the market. He could probably supply only 50. Okay. Whereas you and me, we are still going to demand 100 kilos only because we are going to eat the same. We're not going to reduce how many onions we eat just because there's not enough. Then what happens is because what was supposed to be 100 kilos, now only 50 kilos are there in the market. Those 50 kilos will become extremely valuable because everybody will want them. Correct? Now, because of that, the prices will automatically rise. So what I was getting for 30 rupees, now I will have to pay 60 rupees for those onions. Now, what is going to happen next? The middlemen, those people who actually make a lot of profit and who rob farmers of their margin and who also cheat us because we pay so much for vegetables, right? Or fruits also. What happens is they will hold. They end up holding. They end up keeping it with them because they are waiting for prices to rise even further. And then the prices go up to like 100 rupees and everything, which happened in Delhi really, okay? Then the law of supply kicks in, where we spoke about what? When the prices rise, the quantity supplied increases. Now what this middleman will do, they will release the onion slowly and finally our demand will be met. Now tell me, do you understand this nicely? The relationship between demand, supply, price, this whole thing, do you understand it? Sanjana, no, Vedant and R, Vedant. Okay, fine, great. You'll understand it, that is great. So you all are able to relate concepts then of demand and supply and price, which is awesome. You'll remember it. This being the last class, I wanted to just, tell you all, okay, see, these are the things that we've learned. We started off with resources and scarcity. We went to the island, we did that activity. Then we went on to understanding the difference between needs and wants. Then we learned about opportunity cost and we also defined what economics is, right? Then we decided that we're going to learn about goods and services and we saw the relation that economics has to what we learned in environmental science about the conservation of resources and biodiversity. Then we saw the next class, which was last Thursday, we discussed about the Indian economy and what are the sectors here. Then we spoke a little bit about free economy, the invisible hand, and about how in India the free market economy would not really work. And it doesn't work. Then we spoke about demand on Saturday. We learned price and we also saw a little bit about consumer behavior. And today we are learning about supply. We finished supply, right? And price is what we already covered. And a little bit about the Indian economy, I'll tell you now.